Now, we have the extension here of the love chapter. Follow after love. Desire spiritual gifts, but rather that you may prophesy. For he that speaketh in not an unknown, that's in italics. Let's leave it out. For he that speaketh in a tongue speaketh not unto man, but unto God, for no man understandeth him. Howbeit in the spirit he speaketh mysteries. Now, nobody there will understand him. And he therefore is not to speak in an unknown tongue. That is, he's not to do that unless there's somebody there that can interpret. And we'll see that in just a moment. There'd have to be somebody there to interpret. Now, what we have here is this emphasis that he puts on actually three gifts in this chapter: prophecy, tongues, and the interpretation of tongues. Have you ever noticed that there's very little reference in the Bible to tongues except in these three chapters we have here? On the day of Pentecost, we know what that was, each man speaking in the tongue that was understood. It was also in the home of Cornelius, and that's in the 10th of Acts, and also in the 19th of Acts when Paul arrived in Ephesus. And we find, therefore, that tongues actually was the institution of the dispensation of grace. Every time it was used in that connection. You have the day of Pentecost, when it went to the nation Israel, the home of Cornelius, the opening of the gospel to the Gentile. Then in Ephesus, you see it moving out to the world. And so we have these three instances. Now, will you notice, he says, for he that speaketh in a tongue speaketh not unto man, but unto God, because no man understand it. Howbeit, in the spirit he speaketh mysteries, that is, he doesn't understand it, but he that prophesieth speaketh unto man to edification and exhortation and comfort. Now, Paul's emphasizing the gift of prophecy. He said, don't go in for the unknown thing that you delight in, and they were delighting in it in Corinth. He said, when you are speaking or teaching the Word of God, that's for edification and for comfort and for exhortation. Now, he says, he that speaketh in a tongue edifieth himself. He builds up himself, but he that prophesieth edifieth the church. You see, the tongue, if it's just exercise for the individual, it's a selfish sort of a gift. But when you prophesy, teach, you're edifying the church. Now, he says, I would that you all spake with tongues, but rather that you prophesy. Now, the important thing is not a tongues meeting, but a Bible study. That's more important. Paul says that. For greater is he that prophesieth, that is, teaches the Word of God, than he that speaketh with tongues, except he interpret, that the church may receive edifying. Now, the important thing is, and you don't hear that emphasized today, no one ought to speak in tongue unless there's somebody there to interpret.